So this is the same model. Let me show you those options for defining ranges for columns. So again, I repeat that if you have to go for the auto hinge option for columns, you have to make sure that the actual reinforcement details are already provided in the frame sections of those columns, because the program may use those values to actually go into that table 10-8 of the ASC 41 and use the values of that reinforcement ratio. So we go to the section properties and then frame wall nonlinear hinges, and then again add new property. Let's say select the type as concrete, and then deformation control, and then interacting PM to M3 option. This is for columns. The same form which I have shown you in the slides is open. You can select the type of hinge and all those options which I have discussed in detail. So for example, if you go for symmetric option, you see here that specify curve at angle of 0 degree. So then you just need to define one m theta curve, and the same curve will be rotated all 360 degrees for any angle that same curve will be used. So basically there will be no effect of angle on the shape of m theta curve. It will remain the same shape, but and therefore you just have a number of angles equal to 1, and that is 0 degree. So if you go for that option, you cannot change, you cannot add new angles if you go for the first option, which is circular or perfectly symmetric. If you go for the second option, now you have to define two curves, one at 0 degree, one at 90 degree, and the program will just use the same symmetric values for other angles. For example, for 270 it will use the same as 90, for 180 it will use the same as 0. So now automatically you see that the number of angles are changed to 2, and that is 0 and 90 degree. If you go for the third option, which is no symmetry, you can define the curves at 0, 90, 180 and 270 degrees, and even you can add or you can modify these numbers also. At your own angle also you can give the m theta curve. So you see here, for the first option there is only one red line in 0 degree. Second option you have two lines, which means you have to define the m theta in these two directions, and third is all four lines. You have to define the curves, four curves for four different angles, and the program will use them to actually calculate the effect of angle on the m theta curve. So if there is any intermediate angle based on the applied loading, the program will interpolate and it will know that how to change the shape of m theta curve based on any intermediate angle. Similarly, the level of axial forces, currently it is set to 1, but you can add these levels also. You can give your own number. Basically, at for different level you can define a different curve. So for example, the number of axial forces currently is set to 1, but you can set it to maybe 5, let's say. And then if you see, you can give 5 different axial levels, axial force levels, and a different curve for each of this level. So the program will know that how to modify the m theta curve based on the level of axial force. So for all 5 levels, I can modify these levels. I can say, okay, 10 kilonewton, then maybe 50 kilonewton, then maybe 100, and then 500. Whatever is my expected range for the level of axial force, I cover that. And for each level of axial force, I define a different m theta curve when I click on this option, modify show moment rotation data. So now see, if I select 5 angles, 5 axial force levels, for all those levels, this is a different curve. So if I select a different level of axial force, basically I am defining a new m theta curve. Similarly, for different angles, I can define a new m theta curve. So for one axial force and one angle, I give these numbers, which is the m theta curve, and then I change that and I fill that again. So basically I have to fill for all angles and for all axial force levels. So the complete three-dimensional behavior of that hinge is defined. Then for each action deformation curve, I can give the IOLS and CP values also, and these are the view options for that. So currently, see, I have 5 levels of axial forces and 4 angles. So currently I have to define 20 curves, 5 into 4, 20 curves. So this is curve number 20. I can toggle between them, curve 18, curve 19, all that you can see. As I am moving for different curves, currently the number will remain same because I haven't modified it, but otherwise it can be different for each curve. So the summary is that I have to define 20 curves for if I have 5 levels of axial force and 4 angles. So that's all about this option, and then this is the option for defining the PMM surface. Again, the same options. I can go for code expressions, default from the material values and reinforcement values, or user defined. And in that user defined, I can again control its shape and define its shape according to my own numbers. So all of that information, if you want to go for this option, you should know. These are the three different views of the three-dimensional surface: PM2 view, PM3 view, and M2-M3 view. M2-M3 view means the top view, and these are the two side views. So these are the options which you will be using, and then finally all of those data will be defined or actually stored in a plastic hinge property, which whatever name you will give it. So if this is the interacting M2-M3, the plastic hinge, let's call it FH1, and I click OK, and now it is defined, and click OK. Now I can assign it to a particular column by just clicking that column, selecting that column, and assign frame hinges. And in that, from that list, I can select now FH1 at a relative distance of 0. I click add, and let's say the same hinge on a relative distance of 1. So the program will generate 2 copies of that FH1 and assign it to that particular column. So I can zoom in. So here you can see these are the 2 hinges which are generated. I can see their values or their inputs by going again to the section property, frame, wall, nonlinear hinges. And then see, these are the 2 generated plastic hinges of the interacting PM2 M3 type. I can modify that. Modify show hinge property, and the same form will be open. I can see the number of angles, the number of axial forces. Here you can see that the number of axial forces is 1, which is 0, and number of angles is this. So program have already modified data, or I am not sure what values I have given actually. So you can try that yourself, and you can modify those values also. I think there must be an option to convert it into user defined, just like beams. Or maybe there is, let me just click on that. So the generated property may not be. So that option for convert into user defined is not available here in this case. So you can explore these options, but I just wanted to show you some of the basic inputs which are required. So this is the same form, the IOLS and CP. These are the default values I just show you for the purpose of this demonstration. But ideally you have to work out in detail to actually get those hinge properties. So this was the manual way of actually defining and then assigning the plastic hinges. The other way is the direct automatic way using ASC 41 table. And that is that you just select a particular column, go to directly assign and frame and hinges, and in the same list the first option is auto. You just click on auto and give a relative distance of 0 and click on add. So that form will be opened, and then that you select RC column, because this is the column. So you select table 10-8 and 10-9 for concrete columns. One is for columns other than circular and one is for circular. And in that you select PM2 M3, and all of those inputs which are required to enter into that table and pick values you have to select. So please check the footnotes of those tables 10-8 and 10-9 to understand all the notations, and then you will be able to actually fill that form correctly for your column, and when you click OK, the plastic hinge will be generated, and then again the same hinge, let's say I define at the other end at a relative distance of 1, and when I click OK, the two generated plastic hinges, they will be automatically defined and then assigned. Now let's go to define frame sections and then frame wall nonlinear hinges and see whether we can actually convert them into user defined or not. Now yes, we can convert them into user defined here, unlike the manually defined plastic hinges. So these two, the last two, are the automatically defined plastic hinges. They are generated from auto. So therefore the options of convert auto to user defined property is available. So currently if you just see their properties, you may not be able to modify anything. So these number of axial force levels, the number of angles, the program itself, you can say itself have decided. So all the action deformation curve from ASC 41 is taken automatically by the program. Similarly, the level of axial force, for example, here. Similarly, the PMM surface also is automatically user defined. The program itself have decided. Actually, it have calculated and then used that one, user defined. So this one can be modified by converting into user defined. So you click on an automatic generated property for a particular column and convert auto to user defined. And now you will be able to modify its hinge properties. So now you see everything is again in your hand. You can modify, and based on your own values, you can just tune it to your values or calibrate it to your own values if you want. So this will be the option for automatic definition of plastic hinges, PM2M3 hinges for columns. Ideally, that P values should cover the whole range of the axial load which your column may experience during the analysis. These P values are there to actually tell the program how to modify the M theta curve based on the level of axial force. So if you want to capture more accurately, you should anticipate the level of axial force in your columns first, maybe from the elastic analysis, and then use that range to actually give the program to tell the program that the M theta curve should be modified accordingly.